the project takes a long time. It is not adopted. The architects should be fired. But nobody will fire you because they don't know that's your responsibility. So Deepak, that
Yeah.
gets us on to things, right? As we see, there is so much of flux, so much of things changing. We have some solutions, might work, it might not work. What are your thoughts around how do you make something long lasting? I mean, like to begin with, how do you test whether something is long lasting or not? And then how do you approach that? I
Okay.
know we don't have an answer. If we had answers, obviously we'll be having $1 trillion and we
Actually,
won't be in this call.
there is an answer. So
Okay.
you may not agree with the answer, but there is an answer,
Oh, okay.
right?
No. That's a
So
good architecture statement. You know what? I have a solution, but you may not agree with it.
no,
All of you,
actually,
please note. Great architectural statement to
so
make.
and there is, you see, there is enough evidence. I'm not just saying it for the sake of saying it, but there is enough evidence around what I'm going to say now,
Okay.
right? So there's a theory called the Lindy effect. Search for it. It's called the Lindy effect. Right, so
Can you
it
spell
is
it out?
the Lindy, Lindy, Lindy effect. Right,
Okay.
if you search for that, the first Wikipedia entry actually the in one sentence it actually explains. This is anything which has existed for a long time and
Okay.
survived, that is going to stay for a long time. So this is not things which apply. It applies to things which are not perishable in nature, which is ideas, technologies,
Processes.
processes. Yeah, these are informational things, right? Things which are informational in nature, right?
Okay.
They will, if they have survived for a certain amount of time, they will live for a very long time. Now, just say some examples for here, right?
Okay.
How long? So you've used, so all of us are old enough to remember stereo cassette tapes, right? So
Correct.
tapes existed for some time, maybe 20 years, right? CDs, right? CD did not even exist for 10 years.
Yeah.
Right, CDs did not even exist for 10 years. Effectively means in the
Correct,
mass
correct.
population. I mean, they
Yes.
existed much before that, but as a mass product for you to play music, for you to be recording data, they did not even last 10 years. I
Correct.
don't even have a CD player in my house anymore, right?
Yes.
So that is some of the things. So if you have to study for a solution, right? If you have to see how long, so this is a thumb rule which comes with the Lindy effect, which is you need to study history for the longer duration and see what has survived, right?
Okay.
So if the last 100 years history does not matter as much as the last 2,000 year history matters.
Ah, okay.
You get the reference, right? That if so, an idea which survives for a long, long time is actually going to survive even longer,
Oh, okay. Got it.
right? Right. So
Religion.
that is a and that is proven again and again. So this is statistically proven. They have you can collect data about it and search about it. So the way I came across Lindy effect is through Nassim Taleb, right? He's my favorite author, right? So he creates this thing. He says, so anything which is not perishable, which anyway doesn't is not covered really by the Lindy effect. Right, which is like humans products which are perishable, right? Which is fruits, all these things, right? So it's not that time. Yeah, a rotten banana is not going to get improved over time, right? So it's only the things which have lasted, the ideas, non-perishable informational intellectual production, I would say, right? Those things are going to last a very long time. So that's what your test for anything, for how long will it last? You just
Okay.
have to ask, how long has it existed before?
Well,
Right?
that makes it even more trickier, no, Deepak. Technology itself has existed only for 80, 90 years, no.
See, that is
What will I do,
why.
no? Your first attempt fails. It's not applicable to
See,
technology in
that is why what do you do when you want to first make a note? You get a notebook. Right, all of us have used computers for the last 25 years, right? But if you want to make notes, the first thing which you pick up is a pen and a paper, right? Or write on a whiteboard, write physically with the hand on a thing. This thing has
Okay.
survived for maybe 1,000+ years, right? Ever since they have written language, right? So it has survived and it will continue to survive. This handwritten paper, even today, the books I just have electronically, I cannot even find them, right? The electronic books, I cannot find them, but the physical book, I know where it exactly is. It has survived, the whole process has survived 1,000+ years, right? Of written things physically available either on stone or on paper, right? That has survived and you can still go back and refer to it. I mean, stone still survives even longer than paper, right? So even if, when you go back to study history, you're looking for stones where somebody has written something on it.
In this case, right, I'm just curious, is it what is lasting is the habit of writing or is it pen and paper or is it stone and painting? What is this that we are looking at?
So one is the idea, actually, the idea of physically writing on something. That is the process which is lasting, right? So that the digital stuff, it is disappearing very quickly, right? The amount of gigabits and terabits and petabits of data which is being generated, most of it is technically useless, right?
Mm.
So, right? But all that may not survive as long as what has been engraved on the stone or printed on a paper.
It's kind of interesting, you know, as you're telling this, right, I'm just connecting it to what Ramesh was telling some time back about collecting relevant information. Now, when you're writing it on a paper or a stone, you couldn't vomit everything that you want about that. You had to think hard.
Yes.
That process which he's telling what is most relevant was a natural process which pushed you into telling. You only had a limited stone where you had to do a carving. You have to convey your message there. You cannot put all data. Now, when it was a digital thing, you could kind of put all kinds of information there. And when you want to capture user information, when it was paper, the paper was only so much. But because it's electronic form, you can have 20 fields there. So I think that's, I'm kind of relating it to how this thing dots connect. So probably that old idea, why is it so strong or why it's lasting? Because that process inherently enforces what Ramesh was talking about. I need to think about what is really critical there.
So one of the biggest things about sort of to see it in real life is what is natural, right? When you say study nature, right? Nature has evolved this Lindy effect to a very, very evolved extent, right? So if you want to, so this is always a reverse argument which you see from people who have the so-called scientific argument, which says, give me the evidence. So the evidence should be the other way around. It says, if it exists in nature, you have to produce counter evidence to say that whatever exists in nature is not the right thing.
Right? Okay.
Right? So you don't have to prove nature wrong. Nature has already proved whatever it needs to prove. Right? So if a virus exists and has existed for a very long time and it has survived, nature has produced it. Right? You can try to prevent and do all those things, but you cannot scientifically say that this is the wrong thing to do. You have to produce evidence against nature, which is very difficult to do, right? So by default, that is why all this, you see this movement towards eating organic and not using chemicals. All this is driven from that Lindy effect. If nature has produced something, right? Which has survived for long and there's a process by which naturally you can and grow things and they survive and these plants have survived for so long, that is the best way to do it. So that's what the theory is. I'm not saying you have to buy into it,
there's a lot of merit to it. And it's kind of interesting. I've heard about organic farming and organic foods and natural foods like that, but it was always from a health perspective. But this aspect of Lindy effect and how long is it, what its motivation, I think that's a perspective I didn't have. It's a very interesting, thanks for that. I think that's a very good way of looking at it. And probably it also kind of interestingly puts us in a different challenge that, you know, we will challenge the old, we will challenge the history. And it kind of is at loggerheads with that basic philosophy, right? I'm going to do away with the old methods and I'm going to do something new. So Lindy effect kind of basically challenges that concept, which is one of the things in innovation also, right? Do away with the old and do something new.
Yes.
Right? So
It challenges that. It challenges that and sort of means I do not know how architecture will apply this, but it's a challenge to all of you to think about how does the Lindy effect affect your the way you think about architecture?
It's actually pretty good. I think it should be a part of, definitely a part of architectural thinking. And one of the things which also, which I kind of found it very interesting, one of the very senior architects told me that, well, he was in Microsoft, obviously, we have too much bias by technology, right? So he kind of says, you know, one of the ways to make sure that you're a good architect is if you're good in a technology, you should have at least 4 points, right? Let's say you have 10 points why the technology will work. You should have at least 5 points why the technology is bad for your customer. Right?
You know, so the counterpoint.
Counterpoints. And it should be genuine from your bottom of your heart. Right? It's not like theoretical. You should strongly believe that this technology will not work. And at least you have 50% evidence to say that it is wrong. So what you're telling is something similar to that. We have to change old systems. We have to change this. We have to revamp this, right? Now, for that, if I have 50 reasons, I should have at least 25 reasons why the old is still good. And I should go ahead with that in place. Okay. And I think probably that, if you connect it to where we start with Gautam, right, when they come up with a solution, probably the solution providers, if they can kind of see, like, how will it serve for a longer period of time, right? And what is the reasoning behind it? Maybe that will force you into thinking of something much more long-lived. And long-lived is not just life, right? It's about return on investment. It is about delivering value to the customer. The longer it remains, the better value a product gives. Thanks for all of you for joining. Catch you up in a fortnight from now.